Hello and welcome back to the next video. This is a video specifically covering runway signs, lighting, and markings. I thought it was better to split this into a separate video, as it would have made the last video quite long and we have a few things to cover. As we have seen, airport signage is important, but some of the most important of all revolve around the runway. We already mentioned the highly critical runway hold line in a previous video. But let's continue looking at other highly important signs and markings. Runway signs and lighting. There are a few specific signs to watch out for when approaching an active runway. First, let's look at intersection takeoff signs. These are yellow signs that indicate the distance you have if you wanted to take off left or right from your current position. These might be irrelevant for larger aircraft that always need full length, but as you're in a C-172, these can be a helpful guide if you don't want to taxi all the way to the end of the active. You might also have square black signs with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. These show, from the vantage point of the runway, how many thousands of feet there are remaining. On larger runways with an ILS, you will sometimes see signs indicating what kind of ILS system is in use. It might be a CAT 1, 2, or 3 system. We could talk for a long time about the differences between a CAT 1, 2, or 3 system, but in broad terms, they all have varying levels of accuracy and weather minimums. Lastly, we have PAPI lights. PAPI stands for Precision Approach Path Indicator. It's a system of lights which shine in your direction as you come into land. It's split into red and yellow lights. If you have 2 red and 2 yellow, you know you are on the right glide path. If you have more yellow than red, you know you are above. And if you have more red than yellow, you know you are below the glide path. It might sound technical, but when you get into the air and test it out, it makes sense. Runway markings. There are a few runway markings that might look a bit confusing, and generally, in a flight simulator, they just get ignored. Let's begin at the first portion of the runway, the threshold. There are a few differences here. Some thresholds are displaced, which means the runway is supposed to begin further down than you might think. You will see a few arrows all pointing in a line. This is the displaced threshold. Some are only temporary displacements, and others are permanent. When a displaced threshold has arrows, you can use it to start your takeoff roll or end your landing roll. But if they are chevrons instead of arrows, then the area is unusable. You are not allowed to land in this area with chevrons, as it's been marked out for a good reason. There is probably a terrain confliction or something similar that would be an issue. After the solid white line, you will see the threshold bars. These indicate the beginning of your runway surface. Then you will generally have your runway number next. After that, you have the beginning of the touchdown zone. This is indicated with 3 bars on either side of the center line. Aim to touchdown after those. Then you have the actual aim point markings. These are the biggest feature in front of you as you come down through minimums, and if you know nothing about runway markings, you've probably subconsciously decided that that's a good place to touch down. Try to touch down on those aim point markings. If you are short, then you are still okay as long as you don't touch down directly on the threshold. And if you touch down beyond the aim point markings, that's still okay as you have more markings to help you gauge how much more runway you have left. These next markings are zone markings. They come every 500 feet until you begin running out of runway. Once the double line zone markings give way to single line markings, you know that you should have done a go around by now and should be decelerating or vacating the runway. Beyond this point, you should start running into the runway markings for the opposite end of the runway. Thanks for listening, and in the next video, we will deal with the forces acting upon an aircraft in flight.